Testing your mobile app on an actual device can be a frustrating experience. Getting your hands on a test device, installing the app, trying to execute all sorts of test cases. Bitrise can help you automate this part of the development process too, and all you need are some tests and their device testing steps. We have two steps dedicated to running tests on devices: virtual device testing on Android and iOS device testing. Both use Google's Firebase service to run your test, but you do not need your own Firebase account to use them. We will take care of that. However, be aware that only one of these steps can be used in a single build. If you try to use more than one, any device testing step after the first will return an error. So let's talk about how to use the steps. In this video, we will go through setting up the iOS device testing step. It runs your UI tests on real devices in Firebase Test Lab. Before you start, make sure you have the necessary code signing files uploaded to Bitrise. Use the device testing step, you will need to sign your app, so you will need a code signing certificate and a provisioning profile. You can read more about how iOS code signing works in our documentation. If you are ready, go to the workflow editor and add two steps to your workflow: Xcode build for testing for iOS and iOS device testing. You must place both somewhere after the code signing step in the workflow. These two steps will do the bulk of the work for you. We will configure the Xcode build for testing step first. Click on it and find the scheme name input. Set it to the Xcode scheme you want to use. The value can be an environment variable, of course. By default, the scheme also determines what configuration type, for example, release or debug, will be used, but you can set this manually in the configuration name input. Now find the device destination input. With this input, you can set the type of device, simulator, or Mac to use as a destination for the Xcode build command that the step will run. The default value is generic or platform equal iOS, which means that all devices running iOS, such as iPhones and iPads, will be set as the destination. You can find available options by calling man Xcode build on your own machine and look at the destination section of the output. But please note that the platform should be iOS. The iOS device testing step does not work with any other platform type. Now let's look at the iOS device testing step. If everything else is configured correctly, there is only one thing you need to do with this step. Choose the devices on which you want to test your app. Just go to the test devices input and set the devices you need. You can see the list of available devices if you click on the input. Add each device on its own line with the following attributes separated by a comma: device ID, version, language, and orientation. For example, you can set iPhone 7, 12.3, N, portrait. Now your tests will run, no problem. To be able to actually analyze them too, you will need another step, one that is part of most of our workflows, the deploy to bitrise.io step. This step exports your test results to the test reports add-on, where you can view the results, download the logs, or any test artifacts, such as screenshots and videos. And that's it! Give it a whirl, and you will see how simple it is to automate, run, and analyze your UI tests. If you liked the video, give us a thumbs up, and of course, check out our other tutorials.